Elon Musk is set to reveal a stunning presentation of SpaceX Starship, the fully reusable space vehicle that will sit on top of SpaceX's SuperHeavy. The event is planned for Saturday, September 28th, and will show the world the breakneck speed at which SpaceX has been developing humanity's hope for conquering the solar system and beyond. The reusable rocket project has taken a huge step forward, and according to recent filings with the Federal Aviation Administration (FAA), a test of SpaceX Starship will take place at Boca Chica and consist of an experimental launch, landing, and recovery of the Starship suborbital test vehicle from Boca Chica in South Texas. Elon Musk was in Boca Chica over the weekend to oversee key construction activities in the assembly of the company's newest Starship prototype. He's just less than a week away from giving an updated Starship presentation, and the SpaceX company is working relentlessly to get the spacecraft as close to a finished product as possible. A sneak preview came in a flurry of tweets addressing some of the finer design points for SpaceX Starship Mark 1, which looks like a silvery silo equipped with rocket fins as it sits at SpaceX's Boca Chica facility. Two of SpaceX's Starship Mark 1's actuating wings were installed on Sunday, the 22nd of September, revealing a serious departure from the original design unveiled by Musk and SpaceX revealed almost exactly a year ago. That's a significant improvement over the first-generation Starhopper prototype, which was retired in recent weeks after making just two short hops, topping out at 490 feet, about 150 meters. Elon Musk tweeted a tantalizing image of SpaceX Starship being prepared on its Boca Chica launch pad and partially described some of those design changes and the reasoning behind them. He tweeted, "Adding the rear moving fins to Starship Mark 1 in Boca Chica, Texas." In this video, engineering today will discuss SpaceX Starship Mark 1, which gets finned ahead of Elon Musk's latest update. A cross between a Dragon, Falcon, and Skydiver, which is coming together quickly in Texas. Let's get started. Musk confirmed that the most recent design will include several legs on the rear of Starship, separating the fin-leg combination shown in previous tripod fin renders. Intriguingly, Musk expressed that he's not fully bought into this updated design, which was motivated by analysis showing that separating the legs would be preferable to combining them. Separating the legs and fins would actually be a lighter solution than combining them. This is certainly intuitive, but it's extremely encouraging to hear that Musk is seriously trusting and bowing to the educated opinions of some of the extremely skilled engineers that SpaceX is known for. Similar to the 2018 design, the 2019 version of the SpaceX Starship will have two actuating wings, or fins, near its rear and another two canard-like control surfaces up near the nose of the rocket. A third non-functional fin could potentially serve as a leg stand in the new 2019 design. The control surfaces will work in concert with very rapid movements to ensure stability during re-entry and atmospheric missions, and also give the spacecraft the ability to land safely and stably on a variety of surfaces. The new legs look quite a bit different as a result of the design change. Since the actuating fins no longer have to reach the ground and double as landing legs, their size can be significantly reduced and therefore placed further up from the SpaceX Starship's Raptor engine section and rear. It's possible that these stubby fins will have tips attached to their ends to produce a more triangular shape. Additionally, Musk published a brief video inside SpaceX's recently completed Boca Chica Starship fabrication building, the only semi-permanent building the company's built at its South Texas facilities. Featuring an abstract series of mirror-like steel panels that created a bit of House of Mirrors effect, Musk says the items pictured will be combined to form Starship Mark 1 wing hinges and raceways, an external tunnel used for plumbing and cable routing. SpaceX CEO Elon Musk offered a rare view inside the company's Boca Chica Starship fabrication building and revealed that technicians had already installed the three Raptor engines on Starship Mark 1. The news that SpaceX has already installed all three Raptor engines on SpaceX Starship Mark 1 comes as a surprise, an exceedingly rare instance thanks to near-continuous coverage provided by several local residents. On September 22nd, at least one Raptor engine was spotted arriving in Boca Chica, but no onlookers noticed Raptor engine installation operations. Capable of producing 600-plus metric tons, 1.3 million pound force of thrust, those three Raptors were attached to a custom-fabricated thrust structure that was installed inside Starship Mark 1 on August 14th, barely a month ago. There's a chance that one or several of the Raptors installed are non-functional spares, but it's likely that the engines installed are ready for flight and have completed static fires in McGregor, Texas. As such, they could very well be the engines that will power SpaceX Starship's inaugural flight tests, the first of which will involve a suborbital launch. The system is designed to be fully reusable and capable of landing on their own propulsion. While the news caught the attention of many, the launch vehicle was still in the early phases of development. Musk says that Starship Mark 1's three segments could be stacked atop each other as early as Wednesday, September 25th, also implying that the spacecraft prototype's nose section should be fully outfitted within batteries, adder tanks, which is a small propellant tanks, its own actuating fins, and more in the next 2 to 3 days. Once assembled carbon fiber tank barrel and other remaining physical hardware, the SpaceX Starship Mark 1 will conduct free flight testing that will see the prototype reach suborbital altitudes and then return to Earth under its own power. In response to questions on Twitter, Musk described the ship as a strange combination of Dragon, Falcon, and a skydiver, making reference to SpaceX's Dragon spacecraft and its Falcon 9 rocket. After Musk's update, we could see SpaceX Starship Mark 1 actually fly as soon as October 13th. Its first test flight is set to aim for an altitude of 12.5 miles, that's 20 kilometers, and could be followed shortly thereafter by an attempt to make it to orbit. Of note, based on observations of inactivity at SpaceX's Cocoa, Florida Starship facilities, it appears that SpaceX is wholly prioritizing Starship Mark 1 in order to get the spacecraft prototype as close to complete as possible over the next several days. Work on Starship Mark 2 appears to have more or less been paused, almost certainly indicating that SpaceX has flown a large portion of its Florida-based workforce to Texas in a bid to expedite Starship Mark 1's assembly. This is probably the result of CEO Elon Musk requesting that the spacecraft be nearly complete by the time he's supposed to present an updated design overview in Boca Chica, Texas. Knowing Musk, it's likely that the event will be held with Starship Mark 1 as a centerpiece, be it in several pieces or as a single, nearly complete stack. During this live-streamed presentation on September 28th at the Boca Chica site, Musk is expected to discuss plans for testing and flying the SpaceX Starship system over the next few years. Last year's presentation, Elon Musk announced that SpaceX would send Japanese billionaire Yusaku Maezawa to the moon. Maezawa then announced that he would not be going alone. The founder of the Japanese online retailer Zozo, Maezawa is a famed art collector who once paid $110 million for a painting by Jean-Michel Biscuit. "I choose to go to the moon with artists," he said. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe for more videos like this. Hit the like button if you find the video interesting, and kindly provide your valuable feedback in the comment section. This will help us to improve.